Good morning. My name is Jane Kuklis, and I'm the pastoral associate here at St. Mary's. On the Feast of Corpus Christi this year, Cardinal Sean O'Malley inaugurated the Year of the Eucharist. He invited all the parishes of the Archdiocese to journey together this year to grow closer to our Lord Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. Astonishingly, there are many people who don't believe in the real presence of the Eucharist, and Cardinal Sean wants us to use this year to offer opportunities for those who do believe in the real presence to embolden their faith, and for those that are uncertain to learn to come to know, love, and serve their Lord in the Eucharist. I was raised as a Catholic in the Catholic Church, going to Mass every Sunday with my parents. I learned always about the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist. It was something that we were taught. I remember as a small child sitting in the pew with the rest of my siblings and often getting, as we all probably did, that really nasty look from my mother when the consecration was happening and we were not paying attention. So we always knew when Jesus was coming into the Eucharist. I remember being about 5 or 6 and then wondering, was Jesus sitting on a stool in the tabernacle waiting to jump into the Eucharist when the priest went up to get the Eucharist out of the tabernacle? Pondering was often very much a part of understanding from a very young age, was Jesus really in the Eucharist? So it was something that we were taught to believe, and it became very much a part of my belief system, or so I thought. When I was about 30 years old, I went on a retreat. And on this retreat, at the very end, the priest and nun that were leading the retreat told us we were going to close the retreat with Mass in Eucharistic adoration. I'm embarrassed to say I had no idea what Eucharistic adoration was. I had never heard of it, but I didn't want to tell anybody around me. I even wondered if maybe if I slipped out, no one would notice if I was gone. But something inside of me told me I should stay. So I did. So at the end of Mass, the priest took a very large consecrated host, and he put it in a very large gold vessel, which I now know is called a monstrance. He came down from the altar with that monstrance, and as he did, everyone in that church went to their knees. I followed suit because I didn't know what else to do. I was very nervous and afraid that I was going to be asked a question or asked to do something. He proceeded to each pew in the church, carrying the monstrance, and as he approached, he would make the sign of the cross with the monstrance in this motion. As he came closer and closer to my pew, I grew more and more nervous. So doing what I often did before a test or many things, I said a prayer. And I said, Jesus, I don't know what this is about. I'm really nervous, but I trust you, and please help me to know what this is and what you need from me. So when the priest arrived and raised the monstrance, I looked to the ground, but something asked me to look up. And when I did, I saw something. I saw Jesus. And everything that was there, I saw him calling me, wanting me, just to be with me. And all I can tell you is it changed me. It pierced my heart. All those years it had been in my head, but it never really gone to my heart. And it changed me. It changed everything about my life from that moment on. I just started to cry, tears of joy, tears of confusion, tears of hope. I don't know. But in that moment, I became his in a very new and different way. That was about 25 years ago. Do the math, now you know my age. And everything has changed. I've never forgotten that moment. Everything in my life now revolves around that moment. The way I receive Eucharist at Mass, the time I spent in front of the tabernacle, the time I spent in Eucharistic adoration. So St. John Vianney says that when we go to Eucharistic adoration, I look at him and he looks at me. And that's exactly what happens. When we go before Eucharistic adoration, when we sit in front of the tabernacle, Jesus is allowed to minister to us, to heal us, to be with us, to transform us, to call to us in a new and different way. I know this may seem different for some people, or quite normal for some people, but I invite you to take an opportunity. If it's something you're familiar with, go deeper. If it's something that it's new to you, try it on. Try it out. Stop by. Spend 5 minutes. Over the course of the next year, St. Mary's will be offering opportunities for you to grow in relationship with Jesus in the Eucharist. We are hoping over this year to offer witnesses through parishioners that will be sent out in video format or offered through written word. We also will be offering Eucharistic adoration, Eucharistic processions, virtual opportunities for retreat, teaching masses, as well as more formation in Eucharistic saints and Eucharistic miracles. You know, if we read in Scripture, in Romans 5:20, St. Paul says to us that in times of increased sin, there's an abundance of grace. In this time where we're facing a lot of difficulty, a lot of upheaval, a lot of transition, a lot of confusion, we know that there's grace that's pouring out around us. And one of the fastest ways that we can find that grace is when we say yes to Jesus. And one of the best ways to do that is to go to him in front of the tabernacle and let him be with you. So I invite you, First Friday is this Friday. Do you have 5 minutes to spend with Jesus? Because he wants to spend it with you. I look forward to this year journeying with you and helping you and being with you and hoping you'll get to know Jesus on a new level through the Eucharist, through the year of the Eucharist. So God bless you all. I look forward to being with you.